Let's see what happens.
BBC Radio Stoke, we welcome the nicest man in pop music, we understand. Mitch, how you doing?
Is that self-titled, nicest man in music?
Yeah, that's right. Whenever we spoke the other week on the show, and everyone I spoke to, I said, oh, he's such a lovely man, isn't he? And they never said that about anybody else.
Oh, God. Well, I'm sure that wasn't what they were calling me today when they thought I wasn't going to turn up.
Now, that is so rock and roll. Look at that. Okay, you were in America,
yep.
LA,
yep.
Last night.
I was playing in an amphitheater just outside San Francisco last night.
Yeah.
Went on stage, came straight off into a car, straight to the airport, had to fly via Paris to try and get here. Got to Paris in plenty of time.
Yeah.
But the plane leaving Paris was a half an hour late because all the kids all been at Disneyland.
Oh, yeah,
yeah. Heard them all on the... And I thought, I'm going to miss it. I don't believe I've flown 6,000 miles and I'm going to turn up late. But thank goodness Tony Hadley stepped up to the mark.
He went in earlier.
He went in earlier, later. Yeah. Fantastic.
You know, I love that. And that, but then, it's not over because you're now leaving any day, well, any
tomorrow.
Hour,
yeah.
And going back again.
Yeah, straight back in a 5 o'clock flight tomorrow to Amsterdam to get the connecting flight back to San Francisco.
This is rock and roll. It's gotten mad. You've gone mad. Yeah, do you know how old you are now? You should do this when you're 20, not when you're 50.
I know. I seem to live my life in reverse. A bit like Benjamin Button.
So what are you doing? You're just doing more gigs in America, is that what you're
doing? It's a tour. There's a tour with Howard Jones,
yeah.
Tom Bailey from the Thompson Twins, China Crisis from Liverpool, Katrina from Katrina and the Waves. So it's one of these kind of slightly 80s-oriented
yeah.
packages. And it's fantastic. We're having a ball, but I had to come back and do this. This is just so fantastic.
You must love performing, to travel 12,000 miles.
You know what? You cannot do this if you don't love it. I mean, there are artists out there that you know who I'm talking about,
yeah.
who do it simply for the money. And there's no soul in it. You absolutely have to want to do this, because otherwise it's hard work.
I mean, are you playing the same songs every night? Because there's some songs you got to do.
Some songs you've got to do, or you're hung, drawn, and quartered,
yeah.
and that's, or in America, worse.
Yeah.
So you have to do those. But when you're doing your own shows, you can balance that out with some of the more interesting things, some of the more poignant things, some of the more of the solo things.
Because you did a Visage song tonight. Well, I did
write it and produce it. So it's something that people like to hear. You know, they don't hear it live, and they haven't heard it live very often. So it's quite a nice one to do, and it's an easy one for people to sing along with.
I mean, out of Vienna. I think it's quite a hard. I mean, I'm not a singer. Young, maybe do a duet later. I don't know. But it's not an easy song to sing, because there's some notes in there that you need to get kind of right, don't you?
Well, these days I've got to kind of take a run at the mic to get up to the note. You know, when you're young and you write all those things, I wrote them all in stupidly high keys. Now it's just getting to the point where you think, oh, I'm on my tiptoes, but I'm still hitting them, so I haven't changed the keys of anything. I'm still doing it on the original key.
And you're cool, it's nice that you're cool about doing all the old stuff as well, because you're obviously doing a lot of new stuff and you're still writing and recording.
Absolutely. I think one's got to balance the other out, you know. In the old days you'd have a record company who would advance you money to make a new album. That doesn't exist anymore. So you think, okay, well, you know, how do you do it? How do you make it work fiscally? You come and do these things because they're an absolute ball. And by doing these, it finances a new album, which keeps me happy. So it's the best of both worlds, really.
Are you as well known in America as you are here?
Probably not. Ultravox were a bit of an unknown quantity. We were known on the coasts,
mm-hmm.
that whole big bit in the middle,
yeah.
and down the south.
Yeah.
Not quite sure.
Was it
about
the Live Aid thing did it for you over there a bit?
You know what? It was. I think it was college radio. College radio over there was incredibly important, because they picked up on all the left field stuff. They picked up on all the electronics, the techno stuff, the dance stuff, all of that, and they broke an awful lot of artists. But all those kids who were listening to college radio back in the early 80s, they're all slightly more mature now, and they're the people who are coming to see the shows now. And because we, you know, in a weird way, we wrote the soundtrack to their lives, and they just love it. They're coming to see it and consume it all. So yeah, I'm known, but not to the same level I'm known over here.
Well, I'm aware that you've got a busy night ahead of you. You've got to get back to America, but I just thought I must catch a quick word with you. And I love your new stuff that we've been hearing, that you've sent me anyway.
Thank you.
It's fantastic. And are you going to be touring with your own new stuff again
soon?
I'm
touring right through until Christmas, that I know of. There's already dates started to get put in for next year. And I'm thinking, maybe I need a break.
How often do you get home?
A reasonable amount. I mean, my family came out to America for a few days and hung out with me. I spent all my money. Like they do. Daughters do that stuff. They bought tons of clothes. And I'm thinking, there go the tour profits. It's gone now. So I spend a lot of time with the family. But they're used to me disappearing for a couple of weeks.
Well, I quite fancy the life of your rock and roll life for a couple of weeks. So, you know, if I could tag along.
2 weeks is about enough.
Yes.
That's it. And then you think, I just want a steady job.
But great to talk to you. Thanks very much.
Thank you. A pleasure.
Thank you. Midge Ure, thank you very much. She was last night in a field with me in a pair of wellies.